हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन। सो स्टूडेंट्स, अगेन आई एम टेलिंग यू दैट यू हैव टू सेंड योर असाइनमेंट्स ऑन टाइम, ओके? बिकॉज मैनी ऑफ यू हैव स्टिल नॉट सेंडेड अ सिंगल असाइनमेंट ऑफ योर्स। इफ यू आर नॉट सेंडिंग योर असाइनमेंट, हाउ यू सपोज योर टीचर कैन गिव यू मार्क्स? क्लियर? सो कंप्लीट योर असाइनमेंट्स एंड सेंड देम एज सून एज पॉसिबल, बिकॉज नाउ यू ऑल आर हैविंग योर सेकेंड टर्म रिजल्ट एंड यू ऑल नो दैट हाउ मेनी असाइनमेंट यू हैव सेंड इन ईच सब्जेक्ट। So send your assignments on time, okay? And today we are just continuing your previous chapter. So let's get started. Class 4th, we are continuing your chapter number 9, geometry. And today we are going to start your polygon, okay? So what is a polygon? A simple closed curve entirely made up of line segments are known as your polygons, okay? So here I have drawn some curves over here. Now what I told, what is your polygon? A simple closed curve entirely made up of line segment. Now first we will study this one, okay? Now it is a simple and closed curve. Why it is closed curve? Because it is having same starting and ending point. And why it is simple? Because you can see that no line of the curve is crossing itself or they are intersecting, okay? So this is a simple closed curve. Secondly, it is entirely made up of line segment. This is a line segment. This is also a line segment. This one is also a line segment. This, this. They all are line segment. So, this is a polygon. Why? Because it is a simple closed curve which is entirely made up of line segments. Now, come to this one. What I have drawn over here? Triangle. Okay? Now, triangle is also a polygon. Why? As you can see, this is a simple closed curve. And it is entirely made up of line segment. So this is also your polygon. Now come to your this figure. Okay. You can see that it is a closed figure as it is having same starting and ending point. Second, it is entirely made up of line segment. These all are line segments. Okay. So it is entirely made up of line segment. So this is also your polygon. Now come to this one. Though it is a closed curve as it is having same starting and ending point. But is it simple? No. Why? Because you can see that the lines of the curves are crossing itself or they are cutting themselves. Okay. So as they are cutting or crossing themselves, so it is not your simple curve. So as it is not simple closed curve, it could not be your polygon. This is not your polygon. Now come to this one. This is a simple curve. Yes. This is a closed curve. Yes. But is it entirely made up of line segments? No. You can see that this is a line segment. This one is also a line segment. This is a line segment. But here you are having a curve instead of a line segment. So this is not your polygon. Okay. So what are your polygon? A simple closed curve entirely made up of line segments. Clear? So students, now I have drawn a polygon over here. Okay. This is a polygon. A simple closed curve entirely made up of line segment. Now what is this polygon called? Triangle. Okay. We are very much familiar with this figure. And it is called your triangle. Clear? Now you can see that a triangle is having how many line segments? 1, 2, 3. It means when you join these three line segments, you are getting your triangles. So the line segments that joins to form a triangle is known as their sides. Okay. So this is also a side of a triangle. This one is also a side of a triangle. And this is the third side of a triangle. So a triangle is having how many sides? Three sides. Okay. Now second thing, that the point where the two line segments meet. One is this one. Another, you can see these two line segments are joining over here. And this are joining over here. So the point where two line segments meet is called the vertex. What does this point call?
So how many vertices does a triangle have? A triangle have 1, 2, 3. Three vertices, or you can say corners. Vertex means corners. So a triangle have 1, 2, 3 vertices. And how many sides? 1, 2, 3.
So, you can see that a triangle is a polygon with three sides. So, you can say that the another name of triangle is three-sided polygon. Clear? So your question can come that what is the name of three-sided polygon? So your answer will be triangle. Clear? Similarly, if I draw a polygon with four sides like this, okay? This is a polygon having four sides, 1, 2, 3, 4. Four sides and how many vertices? 1, 2, 3, 4. So a four-sided polygon is known as your quadrilateral. Okay? So a four-sided polygon is known as your quadrilateral. In page number 133, you are having different types of polygon. That is your triangle, quadrilateral, pentagon, hexagon. You have to draw them in your copy and you have to write the numbers of their sides as well as their name. For example, first you will draw triangle. Then how many sides does a triangle have? 3. And what is its name? Triangle. Clear? So in this way you have to write them. In page number 133, they have given you different types of polygons. Clear? Next topic, we are having your perimeter. So what is a perimeter? The distance around a closed figure or shape is called its perimeter. Okay? So here I have drawn a shape. It is a four-sided figure. So that's why it is called a quadrilateral. Okay? So if you take the distance like this, this distance I have given as A, this one is your B, this one is your C, and this one is your D. Okay? So the distance around a closed figure is called its perimeter. Or you can say perimeter is the sum of length of all the sides of a given figure. So if we consider this figure, what is this side? This is A, this side is your B, this side is your C, and then this one is your D. So if we do the sum of length of each side of the given figure, then we got the perimeter of the figure. So what is perimeter? Perimeter is the sum of boundaries. In simple language, you can say the sum of boundaries is known as your perimeter. Next, we are having perimeter of a rectangle. So I have drawn a rectangle over here. And I told you that what is the perimeter? The sum of boundaries. Okay, so its first boundary is AB. So you will write AB plus this is your BC. BC plus this one is your CD. CD plus this one is your DA. So DA. Okay, so this is your perimeter. Perimeter we usually denote with capital P. So perimeter of this rectangle is AB plus BC plus CD plus DA. Clear? Now, as we know that the opposite side of our rectangle are equal, it means this AB is equals to BC and this AD is equals to BC. Why? Because in a rectangle, the opposite sides are equal. So, can I write this AB as AB only plus BC and then what I'm having? CD. I told you this CD is equals to AB. So, can I write AB in place of CD? Why? Because CD is equals to AB plus DA. Now, what is your DA? DA is equals to BC. So, right here, BC. Clear? This line is clear. What I have done, I have replaced this CD with AB as AB is equals to CD. And I have replaced this DA with BC as DA is equals to BC. Now, how many AB you are having? 1, 2. So, it becomes 2. AB, okay, plus how many BC? 1, 2. You will write 2 BC. Clear? Now this is your 2 AB and this one is your 2 BC. If I write 2 over here and write this AB plus BC in bracket, so is it okay? I have taken 2 common. Okay, now what is this AB? This is your length. Okay, so you will write 2 in place of AB, I have written L. Why L? Because this is the length. Okay. And this one is your breadth. L plus B. So the perimeter of a rectangle is 2 in bracket L plus B. This is the general formula for finding the perimeter of a rectangle. Okay. And you have to learn this formula only. this is only the explanation. You don't need to learn it. It's just a way of telling you that how we got this formula. The only thing which you have to keep in mind is this formula, that the perimeter of a rectangle is 2 in bracket. This is called your bracket. And now we will do one question based on perimeter of a rectangle. So what is the formula for perimeter of a rectangle? The perimeter of rectangle is equals to 2 in bracket L plus B. This is the only formula which we got. Okay, now you have to put the values. 2 will be written as it is. Now what you are having? Bracket. So start a bracket. Now what they have given you? L. L means length. What is the length? 15. So you will write 15. Now next we are having plus. So you will put a plus. Then you are having B. B means breadth. What is the breadth? 10. So you will write 10 over here. Clear? Now this will be 2 in bracket 15 plus 10 will be 25. Clear? Now just keep this thing in mind that if there is no sign between them, here we are not having a sign. So it means you have a multi, you have to multiply them. 2 into 25 and 25 twos are 50. Clear? And the unit of perimeter is same as what they have given you, the unit of length. So if they have given it centimeter, so your answer will be 50 centimeter. Okay, the unit of perimeter will be same, the unit of length or breadth, whatever they have given you. Okay, next we are having perimeter of a square. Now here I have drawn a square. I told we know that what is a square if all the sides of a quadrilateral are equal. If this is also 6, this is also 6, this is also 6, this is all. If all the sides are equal, then it is known as to be square. Okay. So, for finding the perimeter, I told you that what is perimeter? Perimeter is the sum of boundaries. Okay. So, similarly, as we have done in rectangle, this will be AB plus BC plus CD plus DA. So, it will be your AB plus BC plus CD plus DA. This will be the perimeter of a square. Now I told you that all the sides of a square are equal. So this all side can be replaced by AB. Okay. So it will become your 4AB. Clear? Or you can say 4 into side. So this is the general formula for the perimeter of square. That perimeter of a square is equals to 4 into side. Clear? Now you have to put the values. So this will be P is equals to 4 into, what is the value of side? 6. So 6 centimeter. Now 4 6 are 24. So your answer will be 24. So the perimeter of a square with side 6 is 24 centimeter. Clear? So students, this is all for today. Till then, take care of yourself.